Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
A newly discovered star has astonished a team of scientists who say that nothing at this moment can explain what is happening. The star is called Pulsar, which is a star that appears to pulse with intense radio wave emissions. However, the star in question switches unpredictably between radio and X-ray emissions, leaving astronomers openly baffled. According to lead author Wim Hermsen, the people creating models will have to rethink what we are discovering here. When we look now to what is so far published in papers, nothing at this moment can explain what is happening. Why is this discovery so astonishing to astronomers?
Pulsars were discovered back in 1967. They discovered that there was this string of radio pulses with a periodicity of 1.3 seconds coming out of the constellation of Vulpecula. So they didn't know what that was. They called it pulsars, and there was a big puzzlement. And about a year later, the famous astronomer Tommy Gold postulated that the reason that these pulses were being created was that there was a rapidly rotating star acting very much like a lighthouse, a rotating light beam. And as it passed in the direction of Earth, we'd see this blink, we'd see this emission of radio waves, and then it would go off for a while this star swung the rest of the way around the 360 degrees, and then blink, it would come back again 1.3 seconds later. And Gold was the one who postulated that that star must be a rotating neutron star, because the darn thing was spinning around so quickly. You can imagine a star spinning and making it once around in 1.3 seconds. Now they've discovered this one that has two different modes of operation. For a while it throws off pulses of X-rays and then changes its mind and then throws off pulses of high-frequency radio at very, very different frequencies and a very, very different mechanism. And so they don't want to hear about two different mechanisms, because there's only one mechanism, the rotating Watsis up there.
The lighthouse analogy for the pulsar's flashes is attractively simple, but because the flashes themselves are so complex, there's been no way of explaining them currently. Now, it is, when you look at it from an electrical point of view, the pulsar flashes have more in common with the complex radio signals induced in the ionosphere of the Earth by powerful lightning. And this may be the key to this particular pulsar, because lightning can also generate X-rays.
Astronomers suggest that the pulsars varying between radio wave and X-ray emissions may be caused by changes in the star's magnetosphere. This suggestion brings them closer to the electrical theorist's interpretation.
You know, I just looked up a copy of Healy and Pratt's paper, the paper on pulsars back in 1995. It was called Radiation Properties of Pulsar Magnetospheres, Observation, Theory, and Experiment. Healy was at the VLA, the Very Large Array of National Radio Astronomy in Socorro, New Mexico, and Pratt, of course, was at Los Alamos Lab, and they did a very in-depth study of all of the known properties of pulsars. If you stop and think about Healy and Pratt's ideas, that this is an electrical oscillation, there are all sorts of circuits that man uses now and have been developed in electrical engineering laboratories that put out different signals at different frequencies and switch back and forth between one mode of operation and another mode of operation. So it's a strong suggestion that what we're observing is an electrical oscillation that has a couple of different modes of operation. We see it in the lab every day.
The Healy and Pratt model of the pulsing signals from a star doesn't require a rotating object or the lighthouse effect. What it says, in effect, is that there's a discharge that occurs close to the star, which then travels along the magnetic field lines outwards from the star, where it meets a disk of matter surrounding the star. Where it meets that more dense matter disk, there is a kind of short circuit occurs, and the signal is reflected. It's just like a transmission line in electrical engineering theory. And in fact, the signal does reverse phase, which is what you expect in that condition. So in other words, it's a kind of confirmation of their model, if you like. Now, this particular pulsar is switching between strong radio signals and strong X-ray signals. for reasons that are unknown. It suggests to me that where the short circuit occurs in this signal regime, in a less dense atmosphere, you're getting radio signals, radio pulses. In a more dense atmosphere, it forms more like a lightning discharge and X-rays are being generated. So that would be my view of this particular pulsar. What Helium Perrette have done is to provide a model which is amenable to experiment and to verification on Earth in the laboratory, as distinct from a model which invokes an unknown form of matter, a neutron star, and an object rotating faster than a dentist drill in some cases. It seems to me that until we get the concepts right, we will never get a correct answer.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.